Radiant Church presents Radiant Stories, a collection of stories that showcase God's faithfulness to take our hopeless situations and craft them into beautiful testimonies of His power, provision, and love. This is Radiant Stories. I'm Anna Rittering, and we are talking to Bryce Brower today. We'll get right into it. I really just do want to hear, like, your testimony, and I know that you have been a musician for a long time, and you've kind of been in different circles as a musician, and so how that weaves into your testimony, what being a musician means to you and what being a prophetic musician means to you.
So kind of like quick background with everything that I've been through kind of spiritually. I've kind of like dealt with spiritual warfare a lot through my life, seeing angels, demons, and just kind of going through visions at a very young age that just was kind of creepy. There was one night specifically that I remember I woke up to just kind of like a tap on my head. This was after my parents, like, I used to sleep with covers over my head. Mm-hmm. And my parents finally convinced me to remove the covers during the night. So when I did that, I woke up to like a tap on my head, and like there was a demon on my pillow.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. And so like just being a kid, I didn't really know what to do besides to like kind of like growl at it.
Right.
And it came back with something 10 times worse. So I threw the covers back over my head, just kind of was just wailing. And so my brothers, we all shared a room at the time. They went up and grabbed my parents, and they came running down. My dad had me draw what I saw. He took that piece of paper of what I saw, crumbled it up, and threw it up against our house wall. And it sounded like a cannon went off in the house.
Oh my goodness.
So it was kind of cool just like looking back, looking spiritually. It was pretty awesome. Very scary, but yeah. Pretty awesome. Then went through some things in my life where, you know, just making bad choices, poor choices, that influenced kind of those attacks to come back. And I started to, and meanwhile, I'm still like doing worship, doing things like, and just basically like I drummed just for the love of drumming, for the love of trying to possibly get something out of it, not what I could praise God with, even though like was raised in a Christian home and everything. It was, hey, I want to get rich, or I want to like just try to do something to make myself known. Especially even though I would like tell people, yeah, I'm doing this for God's glory. It was, you know, you're just masking it. So, you know, so there was one time we were hired for a youth retreat, and me and my brothers were talking with a friend of ours, and I was just kind of sharing just spiritually what I've been through. He just said, well, it sounds like the enemy's threatened of what you'll become once you decide to like fully surrender your heart over to God. And so I never thought about it that way. I never really wanted to pursue more than what my parents would bring us to church, just because it just wasn't for me at the time. Finally just overcame that and started playing at a lot of churches around the area, networking with people. And through that, you just keep getting more calls and more calls, like, hey, we need a drummer this Sunday. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, I'm going to try to use everything that God's given me to glorify Him. And through that, it's been really cool, though, to see in a racial perspective. I played with a lot of black gospel people, played with a lot of old hymnal people, played with a lot of stuff that we do at Radiant. You know, it's kind of a mix of everything that is still around. You know, it's kind of cool just to see, even though you're young, you're white, you're different, like, I don't know what else to say, but it was through that, I think I've created a lot of different relationships with a lot of different people in the area. And so when you're going around, I feel like there's some relationships that have either been restored or just reborn through that. Because now you obviously have scheduling conflicts. And so, well, then that brings about, well, I'm playing for this person, and then they have to call that person to say, like, hey, do you really need him? I've seen friendships kind of grow out of that, just because drummers are sparse. But yeah, it's just been a crazy ride just seeing God restore and connect just multiple generations, multiple races through something that, you know, I just thought was fun.
You're kind of a special kind of witness within the church. I feel like the Lord has created you to be a relationship builder, just like what you were saying. What do you feel like there was a, like a recommitting moment where you were kind of walking through the intensity of your teen years and that spiritual warfare coming back again? Was there a recommitment moment where you were just like, I don't know if I can do this, but I guess that I should?
A defining moment for me was through another conference that I was playing at. They paid for us all to go to this conference in Ohio. That was the first time as an adult, I'd say, I really fully experienced just the presence of the Holy Spirit. I got to experience just the weightiness of the presence of God. I got to experience, like, I opened my eyes and, like, they weren't using fog machines or anything at this, but, like, everything was just really hazy. The speaker at the time, he was talking about sometimes the presence of God will just be so overbearing that you're, that you just, like, your legs begin to shake. And at that time, like, I was like, okay, that's weird. But then within like 5 or 10 minutes after that, my legs just began to just not be able to hold me up. And it was everything that I could do to hold myself up. That was pretty much a redefining moment for me.
What do you feel like the Lord is leading you into? Do you feel like you are walking in your calling? Do you feel like the Lord is calling you into something bigger? Do you have any inkling? Do you have any dreams that you share with the Lord?
Yeah. Well, obviously, just like being a drummer full time would be awesome.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's just a dream. If God wants that for me, then yeah, I think that'd be cool.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, there's been times where when I started coming to Radiant, Pastor Tony at the time was speaking. He was talking about leadership. And then I just had something laid on my heart about leadership. And at that time, I just started a new job and was overwhelmed. But it was a lot of fun to be able to push myself in areas that I've never really had to grow in before from a leadership perspective. And they're coming up to me saying, just what a wonderful job I've been doing with the employees that they've put underneath me.
Which speaks to the connection portion too, that I feel like you're gifted in, is bringing people together and building relationships. So,
which is crazy to think of. And so I feel like there's a different calling leadership-wise that I'm growing in, continue to grow in, both on a professional level and spiritual level.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. There's probably still stuff on my heart that he needs to work on. We continually grow.
I feel really strongly that it is both spheres of your life. There is a strong call for leadership, and you have a gifting in connection and relationship. That's just kind of the theme that I'm hearing. I've been a part of ministry for a long time, and I've never seen like what you and your brothers do in terms of traveling around and getting to know really the heart of the local church. Like, I've seen musicians come in and they'll get hired for Sundays and stuff like that. And that's really cool. You know, you get to know churches, you get paid, you know, that type of thing. You get hired for events and stuff like that. But there's a really unique relationship that you and your brothers have built with the local church, because Kalamazoo isn't very big.
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool, Bryce. I think that your journey, especially in spiritual warfare and being a seer, it's something really scary, I think, for kids and parents. Is there something that you would want to say to maybe your younger self, or you know, even a teenager, a 16-year-old guy that's maybe in the same position as you?
You know, I think my parents did a very good job in kind of coaching me through that. But I would just say to a younger kid that's going through something like that, that it's, for one, you're not alone. You don't really know who else is going through that. And for me, I never really thought that anybody would believe me if I did say something.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say just to a younger kid, like, express that to your parents and ask for more information. Make sure you check up on your kid every once in a while to see if they're still having either like night terrors whatever, because it really could just be an attack of the enemy trying to subdue them from pursuing what they want in Christ. To a teenager, I would say your best decision would be to press in even more so, because like Pastor Lee says it, Pastor John says it, that just lets you know you're doing something right. And so if you're, if you can, you know, muster the strength to push on and press on, eventually, it's not that those will go away, but you'll know and you'll be able to stand in Christ and say, look, this isn't going to happen. I'm going to sleep tonight. Or even at 27, I still wake up sometimes and just feel that anxiety of just something hovering over me. That's when I just start to pray. And it's not an instant like, okay, I'm headed back to bed. Sometimes I have to read my Bible. Sometimes I have to play worship music. Just keep on pressing in and lay hold of your claim on that room and who is in it, and that they're going to be a person for Christ, and that the enemy can't come in and try to hinder that.
And without the pressing in and without the obedience of recognizing what you went through, pressing even further into the Lord, that choice that you made to say yes to him in the midst of truly the turmoil that you were going through, like daily, it brought freedom and it brought revelation.
Yeah, exactly.
Of, you know, that calling and leadership. I feel like that's really special and profound and a really important piece of the encouragement that you're giving through this.
Yeah, that's good.
Thank you for telling me your story. I had no idea about any of that. I don't know. I don't know a lot of seers for sure. So I think that's really cool.
Yeah, it's fun. Blessing.
It's fun.
It's a blessing and a curse. I feel like.
Yeah. Thank you so much for being here. It's wild. This has been Radiant Stories. Click subscribe to get a brand new story delivered to you every Monday.